Dear friends, today let us discuss about Lenz's law and how to find the direction of induced current. Lenz's law is very important in electromagnetic induction. It gives the direction of induced current. So, finding induced current is one of the very important aspects in electromagnetic induction. In fact, it signifies the law of conservation of energy. So, energy of a system is always constant. The Lenz law in fact exactly states that the direction of whatever induced current will always be to minimize a change in magnetic flux. The direction of induced current will be to minimize a change in magnetic flux. It exactly means it. How to understand the Lenz law here? We can understand the Lenz law just like the mass, the way how it resists the change to its velocity in mechanics due to inertia, first law of Newton. In electromagnetic induction also, conducting loops or hoops resist the change to the magnetic flux inside them. How? By creating their own magnetic flux to minimize the change. That means, if you take conducting loops, they always oppose the change in flux. That is what is the actual essence of this particular thing. That really correct, because it is in accordance with law of conservation of energy. For example, to explain it, let us take law of conservation of energy. See, take a coil, a closed loop. There is a closed coil, ring. Let us suppose that magnetic field is acting here in this direction along y-axis. Let us suppose that the magnetic field is increasing. If you increase the magnetic field, what will happen? The flux inside this coil also increases. The flux lines inside also increases. So when the flux inside increases, let us suppose that the current is induced in this direction, let us say. Then what will happen when current is induced? Then automatically, that induced current will in turn produce the magnetic field. So magnetic field increases. That increased magnetic field in turn will again induce the current. This process goes on and on and on. And finally, what will happen? There is very huge amount of current for no reason. We don't find any source associated with that which violates the law of conservation of energy. That means, here, if you just increase the magnetic field slightly and leave it, the current increases on and on and on, and finally, tremendous amount of current will be produced for no reason. So you can't find a source nearby, you can't find the reason for it. This is what exactly is called the violation of law of conservation of energy. Hence, in order to obey the law of conservation of energy, induced current will be produced so as to oppose the change in magnetic flux. For example, let us see the diagram in the second picture. Let us say B is into the magnetic field. Here the magnetic field is into the plane. Let us suppose that B is increasing. When B is increasing, the flux inside this coil, outside the flux is not at all important for us. The flux inside the coil is increasing. Yes or no? When the flux inside the coil is increasing, Lenz's law don't like the change of flux. So Lenz's law won't mind the flux. But Lenz's law opposes the change in flux. So here, as magnetic field is increasing, the flux inside the coil also increases, or the ring, whatever is increasing. So it wants to oppose. How to oppose it? By inducing some current. So how can it oppose it? By inducing the magnetic field in the opposite direction. That means dot. Dot means field outside. Already existing magnetic field is inside. So in order to oppose, induced magnetic field will be in the opposite direction. That is outside. So how to induce the magnetic field outside? So by inducing current in anti-clockwise direction, this can be achieved. So direction of induced current will be anti-clockwise. So this is exactly how we can understand the conservation of energy. So we always say that Lenz's law is law of conservation of energy in EMI, electromagnetic induction. Just I will try to explain this direction of induced current in various examples. The first example, this is a bar magnet, north and south poles. We all know that the magnetic lines around a bar magnet run from north to south outside and south to north inside. They are closed loops, north to south outside and south to north inside. They are not open curves, they are closed loops. This is a ring, metal ring, conducting loop we have taken. What will happen if you push the magnet towards the coil, towards right? So, the flux inside this coil increases. According to Lenz's law, it resists the change in flux. There is an increase in flux, it has to oppose the flux. So, how to resist it, how to oppose it? By inducing current. What should be the direction of induced current so as to oppose the incoming bar magnet? So, this being a north pole, another north pole only will oppose it. Like poles repel each other. So, in order to create this face as north pole, current will be induced in this direction. Very clearly shown. That can be understood by seeing this right hand thumb rule. You can see this. So, in order to create the magnetic field, oppose, incoming magnetic field is towards right, you want to oppose it, so you have to create magnetic field towards left. So, for that, current should flow in this direction. Very clearly shown in the figure. Similarly, when the magnet is taken away, when it is taken out, so magnetic field lines are decreasing. Flux inside the ring decreases. In order to increase the flux, it has to induce the current in clockwise direction, which is very clearly shown in the figure. Even right hand thumb rule also suggests the same. So it is perfectly in accordance with law of conservation of energy. Let us take one more example here. There is a uniform magnetic field into the plane. Let us suppose that the magnetic field here is increasing. When B is increasing, what will happen? The flux inside this particular closed loop also increases. Lenz's law always resists the change in flux. So, in order to change in flux, what it should do? It should produce the magnetic field opposite to it. Excuse me. How to produce the magnetic field in the opposite direction? By inducing current in anti-clockwise direction. So, in order to oppose the increase in magnetic field, direction of induced current will be anti-clockwise. When induced current is anti-clockwise, then it will produce its own field in the outward direction so that it can oppose the already existing magnetic field inside. Coming to the right hand side, here B is decreasing. Previously it is increasing, now it is decreasing. When magnetic field is decreasing, what will happen now? The flux inside the coil also decreases. Flux inside the coil also decreases. Okay.